Patty Simpson, and today we're going to make a frequency distribution table with quantitative data. When we begin this, we need to first know how many bins or classes we're going to use. In this particular problem, we're going to choose to use 6 classes. So we're going to use 6 classes or bins. It's kind of an arbitrary thing that we're choosing. Depending on the data, we'll choose 6. Now, to find our minimum bin width, we're going to take our maximum data value and subtract our minimum data value and divide that by the number of bins that we have. So in this case, our maximum value is 72. So I'm going to take that 72 and I'm going to subtract our minimum value, which is 18. And then I'm going to divide that by the number of bins I have, which is 6. So 72 minus 18 is 54, divided by 6 gives me 9. Now that's the minimum that I can have my bin widths be. But maybe I want to use a nice round number, something that's kind of pretty and easy to count by. And 9 is really close to 10. So let's use 10. So now that we've decided on how wide our bins or our classes are going to be, we need to decide where we're going to start. And in order to do that, we look at our data set and we say, well, my minimum number there is 18. So I need to make sure that my first class includes that number 18. And again, I'm kind of looking to see what's a nice round number to begin with that's close to 18. And 15 fits that description. So as we begin to make our classes using all that information, I'm going to take that 15 and then I'm going to take my bin width of 10 and I'm just going to count by 10s. So here's 15 and then I've got 25 would be my next beginning of the class, then 35, 45, 55, and 65, and that should give me 6 classes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, those are gonna be the minimum values of each of those classes. Then from there, we need our maximum value of our classes. Well, we're not gonna quite make it to 25, so all of our numbers between 15 and 24 will be in this class. All of our data values that are between 25 and I'm just going to count by 10s again, 34 will be in that class. From 35 to 44 will be in this class. And again, I'm just counting by 10s over here to get those maximum values of my classes or my bins. Now we want to check and make sure that all of our data values fit within a class here or a bin. And sure enough, my lowest number was 18, so he has a home, and my maximum number was 72, so he has a home, so everybody has a class or a bin to belong to. Okay, then with a frequency distribution table, we have our classes, but then we also need our frequencies. So in the table, I'm going to put the frequencies. Okay, now to find the frequencies, all I do is I count my data that's within this class. So I'm looking for all the data there that's from 15 to 24. And to help me to count it, I'm gonna just circle my data with different colors. So I'm gonna circle and find all the data that's between 15 and 24. So I'm gonna take a color here, and this is between 15, so there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 values there that are between 15 and 24. So I have 6 of those. Then I'm going to find all the data between 25 and 34. And again, I'm going to use a different color just so make sure I get this correct. So 25. 25 to 34. I have one, two of those guys. Oh, there's another one. Three. So there are three there between 25 and 34. From 35 to 44, there are 35 to 44. There's one, two, there. And then from 45 to 54, I have one, two, three, and four. And then from 55 to 64, I don't see any in there, my ones that are left. And then from 65 to 74, well, that's going to be the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 that are left there. Now, to check to make sure that I have the right frequencies here or that I have enough, I'm just going to add them up and make sure that I have the same number as I have in my data set. So in my data set, there are 20 observations there. So I'm going to make sure this adds up to 20. That's 9, 11, 15, and 5 does make 20. So at least my count adds up to how many there are. So then here is my frequency distribution table. We're going to use this information in some further videos to help us make a histogram, a frequency polygon, and an ogive. So come back and see those videos.